Let's continue the search for... Oh, hey, land. Let's upgrade something here. Demons will explode on that. Bigger demon, bigger explosion. Yeah, sounds about right. I just have to go all the way back. I should have known. Yep, this is uncomfortable. Okay, so that's the main pathway, yeah?
Yeah. There is a Sentinel power core nearby. You can use it to activate the mech and clear a path forward.
Yep, so that is. Oh. Took me a moment. Almost missed this thing. Album found. I don't scan it. Nice. Let's see if there is still that one over there. That one over there. I'm not sure I can. I don't think I can get up there, is it? And the pistol. And more lore. Is there something else about too? Let's treat that while with enemies walking in. In the first time of grief, when King Edrex took the throne, a blessing came to the people of Argenta. White porcelain beings from a world above our own brought gifts to the Nord. Observers to our great deeds, admirers of our convictions. They sought to make bond with our swords and bring lasting order to our world. These were beings unlike any we had seen before. Sword and shield held no weight against them, for the ethereal flesh of these luminous beings seemed unbound by mortality. Able to move through time and space, they held sway over all dominions of the known and unknown dimensions. Through their ways, we grew stronger, our society bolstered by their infinite wisdom, and all now in power, assuring our people's safety for all time, in this world and the next. Where we sharpened the blade and mastered our magic, they bolstered the soul and spirit. That would no longer be the end for our people. The ones we call the Makers, our new allies in this brutal world, have given us the security in death we fought so hard to achieve in life. We would find eternal peace, and our minds would rest easy with the knowledge that those we fought alongside in battle would join us in the lands beyond the mortal plane. The strength of our ways, the purity of our essence, would by Maker Law grant us passage to the great city in the clouds. There, and women and children, warriors and kin alike, would welcome us. We adopted the holy doctrines of the Makers, gifted in exchange with the chance to earn eternal rest for our immortal souls in blessed Urdak. The covenant we held now under the embrace of our new gods, fostered a peace we had never known, for they were unlike the first ones, whose presence offered no paradise from fear and the uncertainty of existence in a harsh and unforgiving world. The Maker's embrace was warm and guided us into an era of spiritual prosperity. I don't like them already. There we go. Looking back up here. Are pretty long, not that I'm complaining either. Yeah, I know the weak point of the relevance. That's not what I'm looking for. I probably shouldn't have just focused on that one first, but... I should probably have focused on literally everything else first. I like that model. Here's another one. A place to land. Nice. Was it a waste?
Yeah, but
it's all worth it. Home point that's like a hidden combat or something. And there's the... Ish, this place is huge. Just so effective to kill them this way. Well, use any other method, right? Secret encounters. Secret encounters are optional timed encounters hidden in the world. Any resources spent on a secret encounter will not be restored afterwards. Okay. Either way. it. Missing on the other side, entirely possible. Step on that. I managed to get that thing. So here, yeah, okay. This leads right here. Esperemos ahora. Pero no siento bien aquí en el suelo. Might as well. We'll grab that. Oh. If you spent 2 hours of stream already. Well, time does fly when you're having fun. But that also means I have to get in here, doesn't it? In there. Yep. Right into the tutorial for whatever thing. Dude, that was a bit close, I almost messed up again. This. I knew it! Okay, so. Sure, more armor. sure when exactly I'll be grabbing. After that, well, it can be too difficult to design. For now, though. Okay. I'm ready for some unlocking. What was that? Oh, probably I'm a fucking boss right now. That's one hell of an enemy, isn't it? There's something in Spar 3. Nice. With machine and enchantment of the makers, they are yet to have brought our newfound clarity to the disparate realms of the Empyrean Void. We took flight with the support of our gods, spreading the enlightening word of the Khan Maker. We discovered there was not one enemy, but many. Worlds and peoples unknown to the Argenta were unveiled, and we saw our own suffering reflected in their eyes. Our rich, righteous army strode into battle under the banner of the Night Sentinels. We fought for the freedom of all peoples from the grasp of those who would exploit and prey upon them. Though we battled on soil not our own, the blood we shed in foreign land safeguarded Argentan Ur. The sons and daughters that defended it. Through the strange peoples, we liberated new alliances. Through the strange peoples, we liberated new alliances were formed, and our beliefs became their own. Our armies swelled. As the Argenta traversed the stars with gleaming warfleets of the Khan of the Makers approached King Rohan on his throne. He sensed his god restless by her disquiet manner. The king and Khan spoke, and the god revealed she had foreseen a schism in the blood of the Argenta. A test would be required to identify its host among us. She spoke of a holy rite to be performed on the strongest of her warriors. Only those that proved worthy would be destined, for the impurity could reside in only the most resilient of our legion. The Divinity Machine, a great tribute by Maker's Cold Aries, would help us to cleanse any impurities from our flock, ensuring our continued prosperity in this world and in the Maker realm that awaited in the afterlife. The Malicious One, if not exhumed from our ranks, would jeopardize our safe passage to the heavenly realm of Ordak. The Dark One was not amongst them yet, nor would he be for many generations. Only the Mother God, through divination and Maker's sight, would determine when he stood before them. The Makers were truth, and only their unclouded eyes could find the one who was marked. The prophecy of the Unholy One was written, but through the ages the warning grew faint, until only the Khan Maker herself and the High Priests of the Order of the Egg still whispered of a heat that would one day come to threaten the way of light. Is that me? Am I also there on doing? You know, I wouldn't even be surprised. Now, which way to go? Secret! What's this? Not sure what that was. What did I use? Oh, super ammo. Yeah, it makes sense now that I think about it. Okay, so... Slayer key. Slayer key will unlock a nearby Slayer gate. Completing all 6 Slayer gates unlocks access to the Unmaker in the Fortress of Doom. Slayer gate. Slayer gates are optional in intense encounters. Ammo and extra lives spent in a Slayer gate will not be restored afterwards. Completion awards 3 weapon points and an Empyrean key. Slayer gate is unlocked with Slayer key. That's a bit of a key. This is on Nibia's other side. It's only starting, isn't it? Oh, I hate that. A new one. Okay. Okay. Yeah, that was a lot more difficult than I expected. Impeding keys. You have acquired an impeding key. Acquire all saves to activate the micro device and the fortress stone. Right. With that, I think we've had enough for now.